Well, looking for life in smoke, it sounds like it's science fiction, kind of, but groups of scientists throughout the Western U.S. have confirmed that smoke is made up of all kinds of different microscopic material.
Fascinating. KCRA 3 meteorologist Heather Waldman spoke with a researcher today about this, and what exactly did they find, Heather?
Well, the study of the microbiology of smoke is actually fairly new, with some initial discoveries being made within the past 5 to 10 years. This is video from fire 2 weeks ago. Dr. Leda Kobziar is one researcher working in this field at the University of Idaho. She says that given that wildfire is a natural occurrence in the West, these microbes have likely been carried around by smoke for a really long time.
So the phenomenon isn't new, but our understanding of it is, and it's likely that this transport affects everything. It's probably been acting as a microbial dispersal agent for many millennia.
Kobziar says that it's unclear whether the presence of these microbes in smoke has a direct effect on our health, although it is possible for an immunocompromised person to experience respiratory symptoms when exposed to smoke in general. She also says that as climate change influences the drought cycle in the West, it's possible that certain microbes may be more likely to be transported by wildfire smoke in the future.
When fuels are drier and soils are drier, it's easier for them to get picked up in the convective currents that fire creates. And so we're hypothesizing that potentially soil-borne organisms are being mobilized in smoke plumes, potentially more than they have in the past, just because the soils are drier.
As far as what kinds of bacteria and fungi can be found in smoke, Kobziar says that heavily depends on where and what a fire is burning, meaning that each fire can contain very different microbe communities. That could have implications for the agriculture industry.
And that brings up some really interesting questions about places that we know have, crop pathogens, for example. And so if that area burns, there's the potential for those things to be transported. Now, whether or not they survive long enough to land somewhere and infect, a crop that's downwind, that's still an open question that we're really interested in investigating.
I also asked Kobziar how rain, like what we've seen over the mosquito fire this week, can affect the lifespan of these smoke-borne pathogens. She says that while precipitation forces the smoke and any associated microbes out of the air, some can reach the ground, survive, and potentially recolonize in a new area. Back to you.